One last question.
Sure. Hi. This is a funding and capital question. I wanted to ask maybe if you can give any advice or share your experiences for startups, companies that are bootstrapped and don't have access to the Samwer's Brothers deep pockets.
Advise you. Yeah, so come to me. I'm one of the brothers from the region. So brothers as in, not the Muslim brothers, but a brother. I shaved my beard recently on purpose. So, no, there is plenty of, well, not plenty. There are angel investors in the region, and you can tap into them. You have a couple of them here. We've invested in this guy, for instance, and then we're happy with our investment, and it's out there. I mean,
what's your tip? What are your tips for people in the crowd looking for investment? How to approach you or any other angel investor? What do you like to see in a company?
Yeah, as I always say, you know, it starts about the team, then the idea, then how you scale it up. How are you gonna make your money? And then eventually, how do you actually retain those people that come in with you? There is a retention process that we need to understand. So the business idea is not the whole story. It is one. Yes, it's important, obviously. And how much committed are you to it? So as I had told you before, if you come and tell me I'm exiting in 2 years and I'm going to make you millions of dollars along the way, I'm not going to invest in you. Because that won't happen.
Brian, tell us your experience bootstrapping, fundraising, and now almost towards scalability.
The first 3 years, we certainly bootstrapped. We did it ourselves. And then, you know, thankfully, we pitched to a lot of different people. We had users. We had revenue. We proved the concept that it would work. Fadi invested in us. And it helped us sustain ourselves for a while. And then the second round with Wamda and Bico Capital was crucial now for our plans to take our platform and scale it to from a regional Dubai success story, hopefully, to something bigger regionally and globally.
So it's important to bootstrap, to put some of your sweat equity in it. It's very important for investors to see that, yeah, and to see that you have proven your model, even on a very small scale, to know that the money that you're going to get is actually going to allow you to scale that up and experiment a bit, but not just purely for experimenting.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's so essential that you bootstrap, by the way. I mean, the spending your money very quickly does, you know, Samih Tuqan is the king of that. And he's built the most incredible internet company.
Spending his money or of bootstrapping?
No. He's the king of bootstrapping. I mean, the first investment, I'm talking on his behalf because I love this story. So Samih and Hussam, they're like twins. When they were building Maktoob, and the first money they got, other than the angel money and their own money that they invested, was from an Egyptian startup fund back in the dot-com days, the previous dot-com days, back in 1999, 2000. So Samih put the money in the bank and kept counting it every single day. So it's $2 million and it's still $2 million 2 months later. It's still $2 million, not spending. Yeah, I mean, and then as well, we know now that he eventually built this incredible company. And all the companies at that time, I remember Samih also at that time together, we went to see a company called Arabia Online, which was the big name, and most of you are so young, maybe you don't remember it, but it was so much more important than Maktoub. It had all the big names of investors in the Arab world, and we went to see them, remember Samih, and they said, we're going to go public on NASDAQ, $100 million. And then, you know, we were feeling like, oh shit, what's happening here, you know. But at the end of the day, Samih kept flying economy class for a long time. He kept hiding his money and spending it where it needs to be spent. And that company told us we need to spend $600,000. If you remember, their cash burn was $600,000 a month, and they were proud of it. And then they eventually ran out of money, and Samih was here. So yes, you bootstrap. He had $2 million, and he kept bootstrapping. He even raised another $4 million. And I remember Abraj came to Samih and said, spend the money. Spend it. Your salary is so low, you need to get a big bonus. And Sabih said, oh, really? Oh, okay, so I don't mind the big bonus. So her first big bonus came in after his second round of investment at Abraj, which was maybe 6-7 years after the business was launched. And then the rest is history. So I mean, yeah, bootstrapping is there's no escaping it.
Last question from the crowd before we wrap. Okay, great. I'm actually building on that. I mean, from most of my story on bootstrapping, I actually was living on just a bed for the longest time. I sold my furniture and I was just in Boston. And I remember at one point I wanted to take a screenshot because of my Mint account, all my credit cards were maxed out. Red, and maybe $100 in my bank account. And I had some leftover of change of foreign exchange that I had to go exchange the bank. And then the week after we got a big deal and it worked out well. But just to tell you that, I mean, the life of a startup is very, very hard. You said at the beginning, Fadi, it's ups and downs. The ups, you think you're the king of the world, and you're down, you question yourself. But it is one hell of a ride. I will not trade it for anything else in the world. So I think with that, we're going to end today. Thank you all for coming. Do keep an eye on Wamda. We have a lot of interesting announcements to coming up soon. And if you haven't picked up your Wamda card and you want to pick one up, Stephanie here will help you. Thank you all for coming.